Hello everybody, have a good day. So we are in the fourth part and we are going slowly, and then we are discussing on that. Now we shall go for earthquake analysis, and that one we are considering here that as a part 4 of design of multi-storied building frame that we are considering here. So coming to that here, what we have discussed, that we have actually computed the load that we have computed. So now what we have like to discuss, that one we have come to that mode, this load we have come. So now we have to find out that you would say earthquake load. So as we have informed that earthquake zone, that is 3, and for that we are getting actually 0.16. Importance factor, that is 1, moment resistance frame factor 5, where from we shall get those information. That information, let me tell you, this information we shall get it from now IS 1893. So we are discussing mainly your say 1893 and the different codes that particular one we are following. And that one, let us just discuss that. So coming to that, so we are having that load, just please bear with the situation so that we can discuss. So we are following this code, that is criteria for earthquake resistant design of structures. This particular code we are following. I think I should show you in the screen itself so that it will be clear. So just let me show you that 1893, they are having different versions. So we are following actually this particular code we are following. So in the screen that you can see, 1893, that is the new one, 2002, and that particular code we are following, we can find out. And as you all know that we are having different zones, now we are having 4 zones. So zone 1 and zone 2 are merged, so zone 2, zone 3, 4 and 5. So we can find out this particular one here. So that means zone 3 is this particular one here. That if you are in zone 3, that was particular we are considering. So this is your zone 2, and then we are having zone 4 and finally zone 5. So you can find out few pockets here, this particular one, that whole northeastern area, that Bhuj area you can see, and there are few pockets in Himalaya that where you are having actually your zone 5. So otherwise majority you can find out actually your zone 3, that particular one you can find out here. So coming to that one here, whatever we are discussing, the formula, that particular one we are discussing here. And then just to give you idea, that particular one code, whatever we are getting, we shall come back. So we are using one formula. That formula we are using here, AH equal to half Z, we generally provide, there are many ways of I by R, SA by G. This is the formula we are using here. Zone, that we all know, that how much is the zone value, that we shall find out, that we all know that how much is the value. Just let me write down that particular one, so then it will be clear to all of you. So zone 3, sorry 2, that is 0.1, that value is 0.1, so Z is 0.1, then 3, 0.16, 4, 0.24, and then 5, 0.36. So this is given where This is in table 2 of IS 1893 part 1 2002. So, we are talking this, so that means Z is known to us. I importance factor, so that is either 1 or generally 1.5, that is the one. So, we have taken here 1. What about R? R we get it from the your one table. The table is table 7. So, this is your table 7 we have of IS. This one actually dependent on, this is called response reduction factor. So, this is called response reduction factor, we call it, and this is on the basis of connection. It can be for RCC, it can be your say ordinary response 1, it can be 3, 4 or 5. So, that means here it, that R value means more, means age value will be less. So, this particular, so that means now I know Z, I know Y, I have to decide R, and the next part which is remaining, that is SA by G. This SA by G will get it from this curve. So, when we shall do this particular one from this curve, we shall get that value of SA by G that we shall find out here. So, we are having here this one actually, just to show you here, that is rock, and this one soft. In between we are having medium. Next one, you see this value we are getting here, this value which is coming up to certain value, we are getting that constant. So, what are the values are given here, just let me write down, that is for SA by G. So, then we can find out all the information to find out the value of age. The next question, that particular one SA by G, we shall get it here. So, SA by G 1 plus 15 T, that is 0 T 0.1 2.5 0.1 0.4, and then 0.4 4. This is the value of SA by G for 1 by T. So, this value you can find out from here, we can get it here. That means, first you are getting up to certain value, you are getting more, then you are getting the constant, and then it is coming down, which is 1 by T. This is the value we shall get it here. So, and this is for hard soil. Just let me write down that one also, the other one, SA by G again 1 plus 15 T 0 to 0.1. 2.5 0.1 0.55, this one, and then 1.36 by T for 0.55, and this is for medium soil. And then just let me write down the last one, 1 plus 15t, 0 to less than equal to 0.1, 2.5 for 0.1 to t, 2.67, please note 0.5 by 0.67 earlier 1.4 and 1.67 by t, which is coming as 0.67 less than equal to t less than equal to 4.0. This is for soft soil. So, this is the soft soil that we can have and we can find out. The next question is coming, what is the value of t? So, next question is coming, what is the value of t? And that t that we shall find out, how much that we shall find out. So, let us see this one here, go back to that, sorry. So, go back to that one. So, we can find out here, we have taken time period 0.09 h by root d. So, we can find out here, just to make it here t. So, that means we know all the information here. So, we can find out here from there. So, alpha h z by 2 I by r S A by G equal to 0.04. So, that we can find out here and then we can find out Z by 2 I by R S A by G equal to 0.04, that we can find out V B equal to alpha H that means 0.04 into the load. So, if you sum it up this load, that load is summed up. So, this is 95.127 kilonewton, that is what we are getting it here, that is the lateral load. The load which is coming here, that is called actually lateral load. This particular one we are considering, that is called actually lateral load here. So, your lateral load, whatever you are getting the base shear, that load to be distributed like this. So, this is our objective, that load whatever we are getting it here base shear, that load to be distributed along that, and for that we have say H1, then we have say H2, then we have H3. And finally, H4. So, we have total load W, W1, W2, W3, W4. So, that means I can write down like this also. And we would like to find out this value, we would like to find out from that whatever load we are having. So, we are having that different kind of load we are having here. So, like that we shall have the load. So, we are having the dead load plus live load. So, that is the load we are having, because of that we shall have the that horizontal reaction for the earthquake we shall find out. So, we have got that one and then we shall find out the load. So, like that. So, this particular load already you have computed and this is having say H1, H2, H3, H4, all those things, and they are to be distributed. So, we can find out the distribution, that determination of lateral load. So, we can find out this particular one here. We are getting, as I have told you that I have taken this one equal, but actually if it is less, then according to the distribution will be less. So, I am finding that particular one h I. We know that h I for that particular one, then w I h I square, and then w I h I square by summation of that, which will give me that q I. So, which is the total load to 95.127, and that load is distributed in this particular fashion. The bottom one less, then going more, it is more. That is the value you can get it from this particular one value, you can get it here. So, with this one you can find out here, zone you can find out, importance factor you can find out, and then I taken 1, R I have taken 5, it you can take it 3 also you can find out, S A by G from the curve you have got it from that particular one time we got it. So, finally, we get that alpha H V B, and that V B is distributed in this particular fashion. So, this is the one that it was a lateral load or earthquake load we are considering here, that we find out. Next question is that we are having dead load, then we are having live load, and then we are having earthquake load factor. So, what will be the combination? That combination will be your say 1, only dead load, only live load, only earthquake load, that is load case 1, 2 and 3. Fourth one, dead load and live load each 1.5. Fifth one, dead load and live load and earthquake load all 1.2. This is the other way, 1.2, 1.2 minus 1.2, another case. This one here, dead load 1.5, no live load, only you are having earthquake load 1.5. It is in the other way, other direction you are having. This is, you reduce the dead load capacity to 90% and then earthquake load increase. And then you find out from the original stability point of view other things. So, that way you can find out here. So, this is the complete thing that we can consider, that we can find out. So, this is the one load condition. That means, if you can solve only for 1, 2, 3, then we can get it for all of them. So, next one, let me introduce that. That is your say plane frame analysis, and for that you require your input data. So, what I have done basically here, now for that I require node number. So, I require node number here, that is your say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. For design we require in the span also, that is why I have given here 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, so 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, then 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31 and 32. So, we have this many number of nodes we have, and then on the basis of that we can find out that your say nodes. So, that means we have 32 nodes. So, let us see that for each node what is the position, let us find out that. So, you can see that one here, this particular value 1, 2, 3, 4. So, that means this one, seven, 3.5 and again 7. So, I have got this particular value here. Next level you come, Now I can get it at the level, all of them having 4.21, but the value here I have taken a mid span, because I have to calculate, I have to find out the mid span moment also. So that's why I have taken a mid span node where I shall get that particular one. What I am introducing here, whatever load we have computed, that load only we are giving at one end, at node number 5. That means we are giving here that value, that particular one we are giving, which is 3.891. That particular value we are giving it here. So, this particular value, that one, because other cases we have not given any value. So, if you see that particular one here, the table, in this table others there is no value, force only this particular one here. Next level 13.37 that we are having here. So, just let me write down here, I shall show you later on, 13.37 that we are having here. Next 28.52 and 49.34. So, this load we can find out, and then we can get that load. Next we are having that one, say, so nodal force, whatever you are given here, that load case 3 only, that is earthquake load. So, 5, 12, 19 and 26. That is the one where you are applying the load, FX you are giving, other places 0. Now, there are members. So, first I have given that element number for columns. So, here this is your 1, 2, then 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. This is your 17 element number, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39 and 40. So, these are the your node element number that we are having. So, you can now come to the table. We have got it 15, 512. So, area I have given that particular value area, IZ, E in kilometer per meter square I have written. The E for that one, just to give you idea, that E we take it as so 5000 root FCK in Newton per millimeter square. So, 5000 root FCK in Newton per millimeter square, that we find out, and then we convert it to a kilonewton per meter square. So, we can get it here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, then 9, 10, 11, 12, left inter, right intermediate columns. First one left side columns, then left intermediate columns, right intermediate columns, right side columns. So, all the columns. Now, first floor beams 17, 18, 19, 20. So, there are 6, because 3 beams, 3 bays, and out of that you can consider that one, you will say each beam actually converted to get the mid span bending moment. So, I can get this particular value here. Then second floor level, third floor level and roof beams. So, we can find out that all of them. So we can get this particular one here. Now just to give you idea, just to, though it is not required, but for your completeness, we actually, this is the one that matrix that in finite element, that particular one we do it, this is the one we consider here, this particular matrix we consider. So, u 1 v 1 theta 1 u 2 v 2 theta 2 like that we consider, just for your completeness I am telling that particular one. This is of course not required because this is the mass matrix not required. This is called actually your transformation matrix, that particular one here. So, whatever I would like to say, only with this matrix and this matrix multiplied with that, you will get the stiffness matrix. And when you will get the stiffness matrix, with that you can solve that, you can find out the displacement, that you can find out here. So, why I am telling you this particular one here, because if you like, you can write your own program, you can do it on your own also, that we can do it here. So, this particular one I am giving, so next 1 hour I shall just summarize all those things, because I have not gone to design of all those things, because if you know all those things, then you can go back to that, how to design that each one, because your, if you know the bending moment, you know the shear force at that particular section, you check it, that is our objective. So, how to find out all those things, that you can write down on your own program also nowadays, that I shall tell you in the next part, last part of this one, we shall tell you. Thank you very much.